Hi Aquarius, welcome back to Omkara Tarot, and today we'll be doing your October read. Let's see what energies are flowing towards you in October, Aquarius, and how you can use this reading to have a wonderful month ahead. And these are general collective readings, Aquarius, will not resonate with all of you. Please keep that in mind. Take what works for you and leave the rest. So my angels, spirit guides, please bless this reading for my Aqua gang and send them the messages they need to hear the most for the month of October. Thank you. So Aquarius, let's start your reading. Welcome back all my subscribers. Thank you for being here. And Aquarius, if you're new here, we welcome you as well. Do join us, subscribe to the channel, become part of us. We welcome you in. Oh, beautiful Aquarius. I love these three cards. Okay, I'll tell you in a second. October, beautiful. Bottom of my deck, I have the Tower. Some super fast changes are coming your way, and these are good changes because I've already seen the cards. So right now, your current energy is the Chariot, Aquarius. So either you're planning to travel, or you have your goals focused, and you're kind of going upward and onward and, you know, chasing after whatever your heart is set on. Maybe some of you are traveling, I don't know. But this is a beautiful, beautiful focused energy card. In the past, I think you've really been strong. You've had something in mind, or you've been very strong about focusing on whatever you are going towards. I think action is beginning soon here, Aquarius, because straight, you know where you're heading? On this chariot, sitting like an emperor or an empress, you're straight away heading to October, which makes you the empress. Now, this is not a masculine feminine card, Aquarius. This basically is the highest level of abundance. Emotionally, mentally, physically, financially, spiritually, in every way, the empress is the top level of abundance. That's all I can say. This is a card which represents forward movement, fertility, growth, abundance, as I keep saying. I mean, I'm shaking right now just looking at this card coming up for you. With especially here you are. Currently you're already started, or you're about to start on this journey towards maximum growth, right? And this seems to be a major upheaval in your life, but it's for the better. It's shaking things up, because in the past you've really shown a lot of fortitude, a lot of strength. So let's start with the Ganesha Oracle card. Let's see what Lord Ganesha has to say to this, and then we'll open the rest of the cards. Okay, Aquarius? So Lord Ganesha. Lord Ganesha, what do you have for my Aqua gang now for October? Any guidance? Blessing? Message? Something? For Aquarius, for October. For Aquarius. Thank you. And the card I have here for you, Aquarius, enlightenment. Beautiful. This is, again, purple is the color of growth and everything beautiful, basically. So enlightenment is your card. Let's see if there's a message in the book for you. Let me read a few lines and see what it says. 27. 27 is 50. Okay. Connect to your true source to manifest your desires. Yes, 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 Aquarius. The color purple is associated with being art, creativity, and spirituality. It's considered a color of honor, courage, and is sometimes associated with royalty. Oh my God, these three cards have represented just that for me. Strength, royalty. Okay, Ganesha is sharing the purple hue to assist you with your spiritual journey inside yourself. By connecting with him and this energy, you will be redirected back to your true enlightened nature. Your crown chakra is the purple chakra that is connected to your well-being in mind, body, and spirit in this life and beyond. All energy blocks keep you from connecting to your true source. Set a clear goal of how you'd like to connect with your higher self. You may choose to be a healer or practice a specific modality such as Reiki. You may simply choose to meditate. Everyone has psychic ability and a connection to the divine. Open yourself up consciously to opportunities that will help reach your goal. To really enjoy living life on earth, the more you can do to release the limiting programs and emotional patterns, the more quickly and easily you'll manifest your desires. You can create your life as you intended. Choose to live fully and achieve real enlightenment where all things are possible. What a beautiful message for you, Aquarius. Wow, let's start clarifying these cards now. So in your current energy, there is the Chariot. Spirit, why is that for Aquarius? Why is the Chariot here in their current energy? This is now when I'm doing the reading, okay? Your October card is the Empress. The Chariot, Spirit. Chariot. Okay. Chariot. Chariot. One more. Chariot. Beautiful. You had some dreams. You had some dreams which you don't want to put to a close. There is something that you had which you've been holding on very dear to your heart, Aquarius. You don't want this to end. In fact, what you are wanting now is to finally bring those dreams to fruition. You want justice for yourself. You want balance in your life. You want to achieve all the things that you have held very dear and you don't want to lose them. You are on the verge of rebuilding everything that you dreamt for your future. Here you are, Nine of Pentacles. This is your goal, this is your dream, to single-handedly achieve all your dreams. Nine of Pentacles. Look at how beautiful this person is, growing money on trees, right? So yes, you are now focused onto your path forward, which is going to take you to abundance. So you're already showing up as a pre-empress, Aquarius, and you're heading straight to be the Empress. Again, don't take it as a masculine feminine energy. This is just the card depicting a woman, so I'm saying that. But basically means you're self-sufficient, you have a goal in mind. I think in the past, let's see what happened here. What was the Strength card, Spirit, in the recent past? Strength. Okay, you were holding back a little bit. You were a little undecided. Yes, there was a bit of a waiting time. Maybe you had these plans, you had the world in your hands, but you couldn't make a move. Maybe the pandemic stopped you, I don't know. But something kind of kept you on hold and you were held back from this forward movement, which is now that you're preparing for. Okay, so even though you knew what you wanted, you were kind of stuck not being able to take action. But action is, well, it's on its way now. It must have already begun or is about to start. So what's Aquarius going into, Spirit, with the Empress card in October? What can we expect? Oh, wow, beautiful. You'll probably be traveling, maybe over water, or if not that, then at least you're leaving all this doubt and trouble or conflicts behind, and you're moving to finally achieve that peace and happiness that you've been thinking about for so long. This is going to feel so fresh and so beautiful, such a newness. It's like giving you a new lease for life. Whatever offers are coming your way are going to put you straight onto the Empress throne. Yes, because now the decision is made. You're no longer divided, you're no longer thinking, you're no longer in two minds. In October, you are crystal clear about the direction you want to go. You're heading that way with happiness in your heart. And when you do something with happiness, with single-minded devotion, there is no way that you will not achieve your goals, Aquarius. So it's going to be a beautiful month from what I see, with the Six of Wands, the Knight of Cups, and the Two of Swords in reverse, sitting on that Empress chair and finally reaching your goal. So let's see, what is Aquarius still holding on to, Spirit? Aquarius, you're holding on to the Seven of Wands. there's a still a little bit of defensive energy, still kind of maybe second guessing yourself. Is this, should I go for it? Should I not go for it? Are people going to be upset? Maybe trying to be defensive, not sure what offers to accept, what not to accept, whether to take action, not take action. There's a little bit of that which is still pending. I think you're going to get over it very, very soon. I think it's coming from a fear of what if I fail? What if I don't achieve my goals? Because maybe so much time has gone by, a little bit of doubt has come into your heart and mind that, am I doing the right thing? Will I be supported? Will people be upset with me? Will I have to be defensive, you know, to follow my goals? I think you're holding on to that a little too tight. It's time to let that go, Aquarius. You're on the right path. The October read is fabulous. Excuse me. I'm going to have a sip of coffee. I have a bad cold. I'm sorry. Okay. So what should Aquarius let go of, Spirit? Three of Cups. Why should Aquarius let go of that, Spirit? It's time for you to focus on your money, your wealth, your pentacles, yourself. Spirit is saying, just for now, stay away from any time wasters in your life. Anyone who's coming to distract you from your goal, because there's so much of forward movement coming into your life, Aquarius, you will probably be receiving lots of calls, maybe lots of invitations, people wanting to talk for an hour on the phone with you. These distractions have to be let go of, okay? Anyone who's pulling you away from achieving your highest potential. You're destined to become the Empress, right? But you have to go through the pre-Empresses first, which is the Queen of Pentacles. So this you have to let go of, that I can't achieve, or I have too many other things to do, too many distractions. You have to let all that go, cut everything out. Concentrate on you. This is your time. Your time has come. What else, Spirit, should Aquarius let go of now? Yes, this is going to be a time for self-love. Be honest and open. Be honest and open with whoever's trying to distract you, Aquarius. Even if you have to leave them out in the cold for a little bit, Spirit is saying it's all right. Because now is the time for you to love yourself first. I think you've been waiting for a very long time for whatever's coming, and do not let anything distract you from giving yourself the highest attention and love and care. Okay? So what can become Aquarius's biggest blockage, Spirit, in October? King of Cups. Why is that a blockage? One more. Scattering your energy again. Scattering. The only blockage you have in your heart is A, doubt. B, fear of upsetting a previous structure maybe. And there may be people, maybe your own spouse or your boyfriend or girlfriend, could be maybe trying to confuse you to say that, hey, you know, you don't spend enough time with me, and if you don't, then, you know, we may not be able to make it, we won't be together, and just basically manipulating you for your time and energy. Make sure that you are still the magician of your own life, okay? Do not get scattered by all unwanted, but people who are trying to confuse you or distract you. Be very, very mindful. You have all the tools that you need now for your success. All the four elements are in your hand right now. The cup, the wand, the sword, and the pentacle. You can make it or break it yourself. Yes, whenever there's something beautiful that comes into your life, Aquarius, the devil does to show up to see whether you are really focused or, you know, you can be pulled away from your goal, and that may happen a little bit, but you have to be that magician who is focused on achieving their goals. Okay? So that's the only blockage I see here, nothing else, except for you getting a bit, either feeling emotionally manipulated to, you know, to end up distracting yourself from what you really need to be doing at the moment. How do people see Aquarius in October, Spirit?
Five of Cups.
Why, Spirit? Why do people see Aquarius as the Five of Cups? One more. Aquarius people do see that you're going off on a brand new journey. This is going to be like a fresh new leap of faith that you're taking. After a period of feeling sad and regretful and looking at the past unhappiness when you couldn't travel maybe. Maybe you couldn't travel in the past. Maybe you couldn't follow your dreams in the past. All those bad memories, of how you felt controlled or controlled by structure. Maybe your boss didn't allow you or your partner didn't allow you or there were people who were trying to control your growth. But they see you now not listening to any of that and actually taking that leap of faith. The people who know you really well are going to be really happy for you because they see that you have faced a lot of blockages in your past. But now, the road is open for you. So let's see what Spirit wants to say here. What's the secret message here, Spirit, for Aquarius? Five of Swords. Why is that a secret message, Spirit? One more. One more. Okay, so Aquarius, Spirit is just kind of giving a little warning here, which I was also feeling with this. I had an Emperor in reverse here. Somebody may try and create a bit of trouble for you. Maybe there'll be ego battles or somebody wanting to not allow you to follow your dreams. This could feel, a little imbalanced here. Instead of fighting or instead of arguing, instead of wasting your time on people who are trying to control you here, Aquarius, I think it's best to walk away. Walk away towards your dreams because luck and fortune are on your side. The wheel of fortune is upright. Whatever feels like a tower moment right now is actually leading you to your destiny. So walk away from anything that's emotionally upsetting you. Any drama that is created around you, any competition, anybody trying to, finger you to get a reaction, just walk away from all that and you'll be moving straight towards good luck and good fortune. So use your own enlightenment, your own insight. Little bit of meditation will give you a lot of peace, harmony to make the right choices for yourself. Yes, I do see a little few people around you trying to disturb your goals, but I don't think you'll be stopped this time, or you shouldn't. You shouldn't, because this is what you're heading towards. The wheel of fortune in your favor now. Finally, things are moving in a positive direction for you after maybe a lot of halts in the past. Okay? So that's all I have for you, Aquarius. Have a wonderful, wonderful month ahead. And let me know what your goal is. I'm very curious to know what is this new thing that you're moving towards. So love and light. Take care. Namaste.